Welcome back to the channel, everybody. This is another episode of Fate, and as you already know, I do many different stuff on this series of videos. You're gonna contact me, go to Instagram, look from Francisco Maya YouTube. You know what to do next. Today I have an idea to do with a video, because this is summer right now, and by the time you see this video, I don't know if it's going to be summer, but right now it's summer. So we have this situation over here, AC compressors. They go bad so much because, you know, AC is working full time summer, because, you know, the desert is hot, especially when you travel all over the states. You have to have good air conditioning. But in many cases, the AC compressor does not go bad completely. In the majority of cases, it's just the clutch, the AC clutch, the one that goes bad. So I had a question to myself: how easy will it be to replace the AC clutch if the AC compressor is okay? Because in many cases, you test the AC compressor and the clutch goes bad, but the AC compressor is still good. The AC clutch goes bad because there is not resistance over here, or you have power to this line and you apply power here and nothing happens over here. That means that the clutch goes bad. You can see made multiple videos that I have about it, and I talk about when the clutch goes bad. So on those videos, I replace the AC compressor completely, but there is an option, which is replacing the clutch, just the clutch. It is possible, but how easy is to replace the clutch? That will be the question. That's something that you have to know, because to save some money, you probably want to replace the clutch, but it's going to be worth your time to do it. That is what I'm gonna try to do today. So let's start with this right now. The AC clutch is the one in charge to activate the AC compressor. This part over here, this is the clutch plate, and the clutch is inside as a coil. It has a coil, then it gets pulled. This one gets pulled inside, and that's when the AC start working. So this over here, this is just the pulley. This is the pulley that drives the belt. And when this one applies pressure, the plate over here applies pressure, the pulley and the AC compressor rotate together like this. But when the pulley, it is disconnected from the clutch, the pulley rotates and the AC compressor doesn't do anything. That's the reason why the clutch is, that's the main reason of the clutch, activate these two things. So when this one doesn't work, this one doesn't get pushed, doesn't get pulled inside, and you don't have AC compressor. The AC compressor is not working because it doesn't transmit the power from the pulley to the clutch and then to the shaft of the compressor. So let's get to that. Let's see how easy it is to remove the coil of the clutch of the AC compressor. Keep in mind that I already took every single thing apart to make it easy to have just to remove. But when you are removing, when you are in the process of removing every single piece, everything is stuck, everything is like with corrosion and stuff like that, and it's going to be hard to replace it. So the first thing you gotta do to start this is to remove this bolt over here. This is a 10 millimeter bolt. You grab an impact gun and just get it off. Pretty easy, it's already off. See, it's not that special, it's nothing. It is just a bolt that holds this thing over here. And this is the, this one's stuck now. I need to get it released. It's coming now. So this is the plate of the clutch. So this is what it got. This is, so this little washers over here are spacers. Then you need to have the clearance of the clutch and the pulley, the clutch plate and the pulley. So to remove this one, you're gonna need a bolt like this one. This is a M8 per 1.5, if I am correctly. You need a ball like this, and then you insert it here. And once you insert it, this one is gonna get pushed out because it comes all the way here. I don't know if you can see the ball coming out, see? You see the ball over there, see? So that's how you can get it off. But this is just the cloche plate. And then you have this. I don't know how this one is called, but anyway, you remove this one from here. And once you get this one off, you remove the pulley. The pulley is going to be super stuck, so you're gonna need something to hammer really hard or the press to apply pressure. The only problem is when you remove this one, you have to be careful not to damage this over here, because if you damage this, you cannot reinstall the new pulley, because this one is going to go in again. So if this one is damaged, you won't be able to install the new pulley. So once you remove this one, this over here, this is the coil. The coil then attracts this one. This one is the one that gets attracted by this coil. It gets attracted in and then start making pressure over here like this. And then this one start rotating at the same time. Everything because of this coil. This is the coil that goes the all the work. So this is the cloche coil basically, and this is the cloche plate, you can call it. So that's how this one works. So this is the one that goes bad. This is the one that goes bad when you apply power over here and there is no power. So this is the one you have to replace. So once you get to this one, there is another secure thing over here. This one over here, then you have to remove. And once you get this one off, you can remove the coil. And you got it off, and then you can remove the wiring. See, this is the whole wiring. You remove this one over here. Then you remove this one, and then you have the full wiring over here. So in this case, this AC compressor is the old style, the Denso style. So it has this little thing on the back. I don't know if you already saw this on your truck. This is a temperature sensor. All it does, then if the temperature is too high, it will disconnect the cloche. That's all, it will disconnect this one. So it is just sensor over here. The newer AC compressors don't have this one. They have just a single wire coil over here all the way. They don't have this sensor over here. It's kind of easier. You don't need this sensor at all, because usually this sensor never goes bad. What it goes bad is this one. So why you wanna have this one if anyway it never protects the coil? So it doesn't make sense at all. And this is what you have to do to actually replace the coil of the AC cloche, AC compressor cloche. How easy is to do this one? It is not so easy. I spent like around like probably like 20 minutes removing it. The first time doing it myself. The reason why I spent that much time is because I was looking for tools to remove this one, and I was looking for tools to remove this one, and then this one was stuck inside because it has little teeth over here, so it was stuck inside. So even after applying the bolt in, it was still stuck, and this one was super stuck because it was with so much corrosion, so I have to clean it. So it was easily in to demonstrate it, but it was so hard to remove it, so you have to hammer it, but I have to hammer it with something soft so it doesn't get damaged. So having the tools is kind of easier. Even I don't have the tool for this, because you need something deeper, because you see how deep is this one. So you need something that goes deep inside, some type of pliers and go inside here, and then you can remove it. I have just the regular kind, then you just use for regular stuff, so I don't have this type. So it was hard for me to get this one off because I don't have the tool, but I got it off anyway because I have some kind of experience on how to remove this. But if you don't have the experience on how to remove this, pretty much you're gonna have so much trouble getting this one off. Everything is not so easy as it looks like to replace the clutch. To me, in my opinion, it is not worth to do this because you have to remove the AC compressor to do this. You cannot do it with the AC compressor in place. You have to remove the AC compressor out so you can remove every single tip because there is no room when the AC and plus the way how you wanna work is not so easy. And plus the time you wanna spend trying to remove these things, especially when there is completely stuck, is going to be double time. So I don't think this is going to be worth your time to actually replace it. If you want to replace it, it's up to you, but I don't and I won't even replace it. I just wanted to see, I have the curiosity on how easy it is to replace it, because I have people ask me, if the AC clutch is bad, why you don't just replace the AC clutch? Because the AC clutch could be bad. This coil over here could be bad. This is basically the AC clutch. So it could be bad. And you replace it with a new one, and then the AC compressor start working again with no problems. But the AC compressor is going to be bad over the time because it's been working already for so much time, and now you applying a new coil doesn't mean that it's gonna last that many miles. If this AC clutch lasted for around 400,000 miles, and you if this AC compressor lasted for 400,000 miles and you apply a new clutch like this one and you expect this one to last another 400,000 miles, I don't think so. This one won't last that long because the AC compressor doesn't go bad only for this. They go bad inside because of the mechanism start having issues, start getting like wear and tear, and then they are start destroying themselves from the inside. And then you have the problem when the AC clutch over here, this one rotates around and the center doesn't rotate around. You wanna see them, this one looks melted around over here. You wanna see them, this one is melted because this is like a little mount clutch over here. Then it's meant whenever the clutch shaft over here gets stuck, this part over here is like made of rubber, so it's going to get destroyed. So that way it doesn't destroy your pulley over here, because otherwise your pulley will get destroyed and then you will have no belt, and that will be a big problem. So that's the reason why it has this. It is a fail-safe mode than all the AC compressor have nowadays. That's right, they have this little thing. Back in the days with the CD60s, M14s, Caterpillar 336 of 3604, yeah. So when those trucks, those engines were on the market, they didn't have this kind of technology. They have a solid clutch, and what happened was then every time the clutch, the compressor went bad, the clutch were just keep rotating, and then the clutch, the pulley, and everything will come off completely, and then you wanna have an AC compressor with no clutch because it's gonna get destroyed. And you have no belt, so that's the reason why they designed this. But anyway, I don't know, but it's up to you doing this. To me, it's not even worth your time because you can buy an AC compressor pretty cheap nowadays, $300, $350. It's still very expensive for some people, but it's cheap because the original clutch costs around $600. The original AC compressor costs around $600 for the Cascadias. And buying one for the half of the price, new, everything new, I think is worth it. And probably you want to spend probably like $100 for this. But to this, you have to add the labor and everything. So I don't think it's going to be that much, worth your money. But you are the one that gotta decide that. I'm just giving you my opinion. But anyway, I guess this is all I gotta share with you on this AC compressor topic. This is all. If you think that there is something else, then you that needs attention, or when you wanna know about it, you can use the comment section below where you can leave that question. Or if you know the answer of that question that someone else is asking, you can answer that question so other people can understand some of the problems they're having or some of the doubts they have about this specific topic. If you have ideas or solutions or better explanations about this, you can use the comment section below as well so other people can understand more about what I am trying to explain to them. If you think there is another video idea, then you can then I can do for you, you can use the comment section below, or you can go to Instagram and look for Francisco Mayuto and you can type anything there and let me know what do you think. If you like the video, make sure to like the hit the like thumbs up video, and that way you can help me a lot. You want to help me more, you can use the description of this video where I have details on how to send support to my channel so I can continue making videos, helpful videos for everybody. Share the video for other people that doesn't know where to find this information so they can understand how something works or how to repair something. And thank you for watching.